eclipse.
I'm not showing any focuses at that location. Shouldn't be anything you can't handle on your own. Carry on.
Thanks. On my own, all right?
Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Trophonaut, and welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. We're not that far away from where I ended the previous episode, but we're bumping into Eclipse already, so that is interesting. Which might make this a very long journey indeed. So I'm just gonna hide in here and then whistle at the watcher. Could actually just kill it from over here, but well, now that it's coming my direction anyway, might as well just stab it in the face. Goodbye. Thank you very much. Oh. So there's at least three guys over here. Might just take out that guy first. And then swap to burning arrows. Just one arrow and that's gonna... Oh, goodbye. That is so hilarious to do that. Just take them out with a burning arrow. I also upgraded my arsenal a bit, as you can see. So I bought the Shadow Sling, which gave me fire bombs, freeze bombs, and shock bombs. And then I bought the Shadow Tripcaster as well, which added these fire wires, which might come in handy as well. I'm actually gonna make a few now to build up the arsenal. Nope, there we go. Finally using chill water as well, and build me some more precision arrows. Never actually used the harvest arrows, but I don't think that's going to be necessary right now. I think that's all of them for now. So let's just loot their bodies of their slack shine gloss. They are rummaging around with a corruptor, but it doesn't seem to be active, which is interesting. So it's also weird that Silence didn't mention that the didn't find... Oh shit, this is a... No, it's a tank. This is a tank.
Great.
This looks awesome, by the way. It's too bad it's night, actually, but I can't really change the time of day. Unless it's photo mode, then I can change the time of day. But I'm hesitating whether those are tanks or actually Deathbringers. Oh, gold right underneath one of their tentacles. Ugh. Do I need to drop down? Oh, shit. I'm gonna... Ooh. So at least one watcher here.
They're inside too.
Yeah, obviously. Is there anything else? There's a lot of things here to check out. Oh, I can't whistle. That is interesting. Okay, then I thought I used two arrows, but apparently not. Wait, is this guy not... Oh, I do love doing that. Boom! And then take out the last guy with an arrow when he gets up.
So they look up.
It's her.
It's not me.
Look around the room.
It's not me. Operation Enduring Victory. Okay, then. So this is supposed to be a military complex. Sergeant Ames Guliev.
I got some.
Titan is through the defenses. Still on approach.
Ah, a live one. And he's pissed.
We got no mobility in here. It'll punch right through us.
We hold the hatch at all costs. Then push back out.
The battle. Frozen in ice and time.
So yeah, they were defending it from... Because there's a Deathbringer over there that's frozen. And then a Corruptor over here. And one over there, so... They were hit big time. Okay. Lieutenant Fiona Morell.
Titan inbound, same play as Akron. Base defense locks it down. We engage, sever the limbs, blast out the fences.
Another day in the life. Reconcile, recourse. Angela B on point. Hoorah!
Are you getting this, Silence? Silence? Operation Enduring Victory. What did that mean? Whatever it was, doesn't seem to have turned out very well.
No, indeed. And there's one more data point I can scan over there. Sergeant Ucidzo Vandari. Holy shit, that's loud. Jesus Christ, that's loud. They were brutally murdered, apparently. And then this one, Yana Mills, there we go, that's Yana.
Looks like quite an enduring victory we put our foot in today. Contact in 30 seconds. Hey, think that's enough time for Sobek to finish Zero Dawn? If this is really it, I gotta say, it's been an honor to serve beside these tanks.
Here it comes.
Grease for contact!
Silence, you getting this?
What is it?
All these soldiers. They died here.
People die all the time. I'll keep going and find something interesting.
Okay, then. Silence is a bit of an asshole. I'm gonna keep going on the side here because I feel like there's something hidden here in the back. No, nothing? Why is this even here then? Why waste my time? So these guys aren't Deathbringers, they're just tanks, normal tanks. Can I get up there? No, doesn't seem like I can. Maybe by using the tanks. Oh, I can. Okay, then. But again, nothing here. And then maybe on the other side, is there a tank over there as well? I don't think so, no. I won't be able to get up there. Although there is another side area here. Oh, there we go. Stranded necklace. Okay. Doesn't seem like there's anything else in the back here. No. Nope. Okay. Now we can death ride down and see where we head out. Oh god! I saw that. There's stuff down here. There is stuff in the back here. Huh? Because there's mushrooms over there. And I can... Ooh, that was not what I wanted to do, but... Wrong button. Where the hell are we now? Because this is not where the game is pointing us towards, but... I'm the explorative type, aren't I? What's that? Supply crate, okay. Let's head in that direction first, then. There we go. A lot of supplies, and that's about it, it seems. And keep going in the other direction.
Damn, boats are full of water. Must have been where the soldiers slept. Like the lodge in Mother's Heart, I guess.
Mother's Heart, that was... I keep referring to that as Mother's Womb, but it was Mother's Heart. Okay.
Log. Third battle of
Corporal Acosta.
The swarm came in from the Pacific, and... I don't know if it was the local Minutemen or the crazy 15th, but they'd set the garbage patch alight. Man, the sea was on fire. That stuff was... The first wave of bots came in covered in burning sludge. It bought us an hour or two of slaughtering them on the beaches before the swarm recalculated. We pulled them inland, back through the Kalmar sprawl. Dropped buildings on them, EMP'd the grid. Standard operating procedure. The last time I was in California, I was 5, 6? The light was like that vintage social net filter that was everywhere in the 40s.
Okay then. So clearly, the war was ongoing at this point against the Pharaoh machines.
Log. First battle of the Eastern Seaboard Wall. Had a long run up to it. This was before Kalmar, and projections were a lot worse for the East. For 3 weeks, we kept getting scrambled out to some coastal burg to train Minutemen. It was always raining on account of Europe already being torched. Block after block of prefab barracks. They were still printing barracks right up until the hour the main force hit. The Minutemen? We ran combat drills with them in the streets where they'd lived, trying to pretend they might live to die somewhere else if they paid attention. Nothing worse than the ones who actually bought into it. Hopeful, pestering us with questions about Zero Dawn, like we know something they don't. I swear, the more we do this, the more like the bots we are. Except they learn from every fight. And us? I'm not so sure.
Indeed, wow. That was pretty insightful. Yeah, we're getting pretty dumped with, lore here, but here goes another one. Reminder again.
Recalls, I've been instructed to remind you of Article 115 of base policy regarding unauthorized use of processor cycles. Specifically 115C. Any holographic simulation not directly related to operational training or efficiency. Consider yourself reminded and enjoy your gaming.
Okay then. So people were using the holographs to holograms to game then, I suppose. Here's another one, just a little longer.
Thanks for the mails, you. Time goes fast on active duty. 4 months with the wreck and recalls, I don't know, 20 drops in and out of the West Coast, fighting with these civilian enlistees, scrappy guys and gals. Their training is basically, here's a DEW, when you see a bot, hit it. Somehow it's all coming together. Between us and the 6th MRB, we took down a horse at Lithium Beach. Pulled out before its buddies arrived, but to see a big one go down. I hope you made the news, honey. Showed everyone we're gonna have a shot at turning this around. We just need to give Project Zero Dawn the time it needs, and everything will be the way it used to be.
Well, it clearly wasn't. So sorry from Sergeant Gulyev, so the guy we found outside.
I know it's been days, honey. I'm so sorry. Deployments are getting real long and tougher every time. The swarm's getting better at predicting us. Less of us now. And we have to put in 10 times the work for everyone gone. Like a family business on hard times, only this isn't my family. It's not with you. I still try to see you. The life we had in the eyes of the people out there. I remember when they were glad to see us, when they still had hope. It all seems to be slipping away. I don't even recognize the places we're defending. The only thing I know I'm still fighting for is you. Zero Dawn to turn this around? Whatever the hell that is.
Metal. How'd they ever get comfortable?
They didn't.
Metal world. Guess they were used to it.
Yeah, everything. We kind of already knew that, but everything looks a bit uncomfortable, as Aloy put it. There's another tentacle of the horrors that penetrated the structure here. Can I even get down there? Because this looks like another death ride thingy. Looks like I can get down there. Yep, there we go. Oh shit, what have I done? What have I done? What if I wanted to go back? Okay, never mind. Damn it! How much did I miss there? Can I go back up all the way? Because I think there was another room up there. There we go. Okay, we're back up. So I'm gonna move towards this room first. I don't want to miss anything. That looks Like it's scannable. Okay, that wasn't really marked. Corporal Sarai, looking back, I thought 64 was shaping up to be a pretty good year. No more drinking and no more mercenary sec work. Security work, probably. Stripping offshore wind farms for the OEZ. Just me and a plasma cutter 400 feet above sea level. Then I got the recall alert. Read them up on a turbine in the smell of cooking ozone. Ozone? They covered every angle, better pay, amnesty for any combine wars you'd fought in, guaranteed citizenship. We should have thought, okay, what's the catch? But what we did think was, I guess we're better than the bots after all. Big talk from Harris about pride and duty. Smart guy, he was right. I'd been proud to be a US soldier. I jumped at the chance to be one again. And look what I landed in. So they recalled soldiers to fight against the bots, because of course, before that, they only used their robotic soldiers to do the fighting for them. But now that the bots became self-aware,
maybe their war chief's room.
They needed normal soldiers again. So another one here, Corporal Sarai again. Last night we got talking about D-Day 55. I was a kid then, only a few years out of boot camp. General assembly in a drone hangar, summer and the sky was bare. The heat was a killer. They say US human combat forces are being disbanded, all automated now. We're lost cycles tech, out like the old net. A million more on basic in a century recession. Could be you'll help build the robots that took your jobs. Or if you know how to handle a power suit, you could find a place that still uses manual labor. Maybe in the OEZ or China, where you're not your problem. Low suicide risk, it said in my discharge file. Okay then, but he got started working on a platform there. But then fixing wind turbines, but then he got recalled again to this war and probably died here. Okay, now we're gonna head down. There we go.
Red light. Guess that means no power.
Well, the previous one we've encountered like this just opened up because we had the necessary clearance. We could go to the left, but there's something on the right here as well. Not that that's... No. No, it just stops over here. So let's go left. In the purple haze. Oh, that looks familiar. Is there a machine here? Because I only usually get that metal bar when there's machines nearby. So those are timed locks. Oh no, that was not what I wanted to do.
A holographic interface. It must be some kind of code. Maybe I should try scanning objects in this area.
I will, but I just want to check out the top first here. If I just move across slowly. Okay. She kind of jumped automatically there. Now, let's scan. There should be a terminal nearby. There we go.
Oh, that's informative.
Well, that is just making it easy. So turn it again. And then one... No. Oh, fuck. And then turn this one counterclockwise. And then the other one clockwise.
Three power lines. Three sources. That makes one.
Okay. Then drop down. Still taking damage from that. There we go. This one is actually the exact same. Well, I mean, exact same in the sense that there's no puzzle part about this, because it just shows you what you need to do. Because the ones near the fancy armor was more complicated than that. Okay. Let's head around to the other side and then scan that thingy. Wait, what? That's not really helping. Consult GT Tech, but there's an audio diary right next to it.
Y'all wanted to know how I remember the geotherm system reboot? Goes like this. Bird flies north in summer, east in spring, west in fall, and south in winter. Didn't expect to hear nature poetry from the lips of Mike the GT Tech now, did you? As usual, I defy expectations.
So north, east, west, south. That's what the guy said. There we go.
Okay, that did it. Sounds like that did it.
Oh yeah, so now we need to get back to that door upstairs. Sounds easy enough. What the hell is that? There's something underneath there. There's a big robot in the hole. Okay, let's continue on, because that opened up the door. There we go. Ooh.
Tools being used. No voices. No clips. Must be another way in.
Power cell.
Another power cell. I only need one more to get to that ancient armor I found.
That is cool. But that probably means that we need to continue on the main quest. Oh yes, Eclipse indeed. I'm just gonna mark all of them. And hopefully get the drop of them on them as well. Is that a scrapper? Corrupted scrapper, that is interesting. I'm just gonna sneak by.
They're not looking for answers, just weapons.
Just gonna move back, let that guy explode, and maybe I get the drop on a few of them. Are they gonna come over here? Because I don't feel like they can. Okay, never mind. Okay, they're almost off my tail. Level 32, that is interesting. Don't really need to waste more ammo on these guys. I'm just gonna loot them and I'll get back to you in a second. So, looting done. Continuing on, doesn't seem to be that much interesting in this area at the moment, but maybe, just maybe. Well, we found the power cell already, so might as well move forward. There we go. Whew, how the hell am I supposed to reach that? Maybe with a running jump from over here? Oh, why am I over here? Ooh, cold. That was terrifying for a second. Climbing up. Nobody here yet. But there is. That is something, right? Or is that just... What is that? Seems like a pedestal we can touch. Nobody else in the room? Okay. I'm guessing we can activate the holo projector, but I'm guessing that's the ending of the room then. So I'm just gonna check this out first. USRC deployment records. December 2065, week 1 confidential, Operation Kickback. Reno, Nevada. Civilian Guard and Armor Battalion skirmished with Vanguard elements of Pacific Northwest Swarm PN-12. Engagement began at 0600 and concluded with a withdrawal at 2100 the following day. Losses in excess of 40% reported. Operation Thick Skull supported. Yeah, they're just attacks, right? Yeah, there's nothing that interesting in there. Now we can see in that room we were in back there. There's another supply crate over there. And then we could get further, but I'm guessing we need to activate the hologram first. Let's do that. And touch.
What is this?
That? It's a map.
A map of what?
Our world. The planet Earth, Aloy. It's not flat like you thought.
Why would I think that? During eclipses, the shadow cast on the moon is curved. So our world is a globe. And it looks like this, from a distance.
We'll discuss this another time. Back to the matter at hand.
The Faro robots were spreading across the world, eating everything up. Somehow, Elizabeth stopped them before it was too late. But how?
I still think she kinda destroyed the world. Continue exploring the Grave Horde. And Aloy, by the way, is way too smart for this. She figured out that the world was a globe. That is very interesting. Okay. There are rooms here, but I don't think there's much in them. Otherwise, please tell me how wrong I was, but I don't think there's too much in them. Oh, they're stocking me up for... with a lot of supplies at the moment. Kind of feel like there's a boss battle incoming. Oh, shit. Well, that is Horus. Are they gonna try and resurrect that thing? Jesus Christ, that thing is big.
The eclipse. Tampering with a metal devil. They don't think they can wake it, do they?
Well, maybe we... Oh. Ah! There's another Deathbringer. Oh, shit. That is an undamaged one.
Another Kulish, and this one can move.
Shit. How the hell am I supposed to do this? Maybe if I started off with... Damn it. And that guy exploded. Oh shit, what is...
They can't see you.
Oh shit! Holy shitballs! Well, that is annoying. Me, buddy. Woo. Oh, he dropped the weapon. He dropped the weapon. I'm gonna take that. Come on. That weapon is still down there. Oh, that is something I can shoot at. Oh, shit. Come on, take it out, take it out, take it out. There goes one part of it. Ooh, there's stuff sticking out of its legs as well. Come on. That's not a weak point, is it? So that's overheating it. So when it's overheating, it's exposing those cores, and that gives me a lot of extra targets. So the bombs might actually be a pretty good idea. There we go. There we go. That was awesome. I killed it with my sling. Ooh, that's a lot of damage coils and a stealth weave. Ooh. Might actually put that on my armor immediately, like right now. Resist ranged attacks. I don't wanna lose that either, so I'm just gonna keep my stealth weave for now. Okay, so we killed it. Now what? So there doesn't seem to be anything left. Okay, there's a door over there. I'm guessing that's where we need to go. Hello, Mr. Door? Anything you can tell me? Well, that was a pretty big boss battle. Although, still not as hard as I would think, because he doesn't have a lot of attacks. And most of them are projectile based, so if you just keep your distance and roll to the sides, I didn't even actually need to heal all that much. Wow, the lights are getting more prevalent. There's something over here. More text. Biosphere degradation. Chief findings. Despite increased tactical proficiency of elite and civilian guard units and many hard-won engagements in the Central European, Antarctic and Pacific Reach theaters, the Pharaoh Plague's rate of advance has not slowed, nor has its biomass consumption rate. Damage to the biosphere has already exceeded 2038 levels by every measure and grows worse by the day. Extinction timeline projections remain unchanged, with OAC predicted for mid-November 2065, annihilation of exposed human populations in February 2066, extinction of macrobiotic land organisms by the end of March 2066, and extinction of marine life in early 2068. Continued secrecy regarding Project Zero Dawn, the utter silence regarding its mechanisms of action and completion date make it impossible to predict Zero Dawn's impact or lack of impact on the extinction timeline. Atmospheric collapse, atmospheric oxygen depletion and toxic emissions remain the greatest environmental threat to Operation Enduring Victory, as well as the widest civilian population and animal life. Operational atmospheric collapse is currently predicted for mid-November 2065. And then potable water shortages. Major water treatment facilities are already struggling to process water sources compromised by rainfall, heavily contaminated by toxins emitted by the consumption of the Eastern Hemisphere. And then military response escalation. Yeah, okay. So both drinkable water and oxygen supply became a problem because of the consumption of those Pharaoh robots. And that's probably how they killed pretty much everybody on the planet. But how was Operation Zero Dawn supposed to stop that? I'm guessing we're about to find out. Here we go.
Thank you, Dr. Sobek. You can take a seat.
What? You're going to thank her after what she just said?
Dr. Sobek has made the situation very clear, General, and given us an option. We should all be thanking her.
No, it's just... I mean, my God!
Maybe take this discussion offline.
There's not going to be any discussion. You saw the numbers. Now, Pharaoh, he'll foot the bill, but his money can't buy the time necessary to complete Zero Dawn. That can only be paid for in blood.
Oh, come on! If we upgrade our fleet, crack the code somehow...
Were you not listening? Robots can't do the fighting for you this time. When it comes to hacking, this rogue swarm is an apex predator. Anything automated you throw at it, they will hijack and take over.
But this... We'd be throwing civilians into a meat grinder.
Commanders, the enemy we're facing self-replicates faster than we can kill it. And it eats biomass as fuel. Zero Dawn is all we've got.
So we put a railgun in the hand of every civilian strong enough to carry one, show them where the trigger is, and point them to the front? How the hell do we sell that?
By giving them something to fight for. Zero Dawn, the top secret super weapons program that will save us. So long as humanity holds off the swarm long enough for Dr. Sobek and her team to finish it. The file I'm sending contains the war plan for Operation Enduring Victory.
War plan? This is a war crime.
It may be ugly, but it's something. Consider the alternative. Dr. Sobek, I've secured use of a decommissioned orbital launch base outside Bryce, Utah as the Zero Dawn staging area. Plenty of space there. When can you get started?
I've already mailed you a list of Alpha and Beta candidates. Most are foreign nationals or subjects of corporate holdings, so extracting them...
Leave that to me. You'll get your dream team. Camp time.
Then I'll be off.
She even has Aloy's voice, which is very interesting. And there goes the meeting.
What is that? What did these people do? What did Elizabeth do?
That's a very good question, because I kind of feel like they murdered pretty much everybody on the planet. And they just saved a few people in the vaults we've come across. And then this, secure comm.
Dr. Sobek, as projected, the Wichita salient has collapsed. 5 Horus-class Titans have broken through. We predict contact in 34 hours.
Everything is in position, General. It took a few shortcuts to pull everything together, but... Zero Dawn is functionally complete. Good to go.
That enduring victory served its purpose after all.
Yes, if we'd had even one day less.
I've sent you an encoded file, Doctor. Please do me the favor of archiving it.
I'll see what I can do. What is it?
A brief statement. An allocution of crimes, I guess you'd call it.
To what are you admitting guilt?
Over the past 16 months, Doctor, I have presided over the greatest wholesale slaughter of military personnel and civilians in the history of... history. Genghis Khan, Hitler, Stalin, Sorabella, add them all together. They don't even come close.
You didn't do the killing, General.
No, not directly. But I didn't wind up the highest-ranked military commander in the United States by resisting the automation of the armed forces. Even before the swarm, Doctor, I was helping death along. So, instead of letting what I've done sink into the murk, forgotten, I sent a file with all the details. Let posterity judge my actions with clear vision.
I'll do as you ask, General. But you should consider that... were it not for your actions... our actions... there wouldn't be any posterity to judge us.
Perhaps. Dr. Sobek.
At ease, General. And goodbye.
Hell of a thing.
Hell of a thing indeed. So yeah, they must have done something horrible in here to keep off the robots, but we still don't know what that is exactly. Okay. That was a weird camera angle.
I had to be rid of that place. Now I just need to find the orbital launch base they talked about.
I've checked my data and located the base. That's the good news.
And the bad?
It's directly underneath the Citadel. The palace at Sunfall.
The capital of the Shadow Carja. Not exactly convenient.
The palace is crawling with Eclipse agents. Many in positions of authority, all of them wearing focuses. The moment they see you, Hades will too. He'll issue another kill order, and this time, the entire Shadow Carja military will be after you.
So, disable their focuses. You've done it before.
It's not that simple. Too many focuses in one place. Each of them communicating with each other and back to Hades, a whole network of them.
Network? What's that?
Imagine a vast, invisible web stretched across the land from end to end, connecting focuses together, allowing them to communicate over vast distances instantaneously.
All right. So, is there some way to cut the web down?
Crash the network. Audacious. Yes. There is a way. A weak point in the network.
Point the way.
I'll send the location data to your focus. Head there, and I'll be in touch when you're close with more directions.
What was Zero Dawn? What sort of super weapon did Elizabeth make? She stopped the machines, but not before the world she knew, her civilization, ended. Let's hope it won't come to that again.
Oh, I can climb on top of the... And climb on top of the tentacle here. But yeah, indeed, what did they make? What did they make indeed? Let's take this dead ride as a... Holy shit.
This should be quite the ride.
Okay. For once, I'm happy this is not VR. And drop.
I'd do that again, if it weren't so much work to get back up there.
So that's the Grave Horde. And with that, I'm gonna take a little break, so thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again, enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye! Yeah,